Welcome back to the lecture number 12 of unit number 5. Today we are going to see examples on method of multiplier. So first example is y minus z into p plus z minus x into q is equal to x minus y. Now first write it in the form of Lagrange's, that is pp plus qq is equal to r. So p value we obtained y minus z, q is z minus x, and r is equal to x minus y. So what is auxiliary equation? Dx upon p is equal to dy upon q is equal to dz upon r. Now how to choose multipliers? So why and how to choose multipliers? First thing is why we choose multipliers? Because if we consider first two ratios here, first two ratios are in terms of x and y. So x and y means this z term must get cancelled out. But it is in subtraction and addition. So we cannot cancel out this z. So we cannot neglect this z, or we cannot cancel out this z from first two ratios. So we cannot consider first two ratios. Similarly for second and third, and first and third. So we have to consider such multipliers so that its denominator must be equal to 0. So first, if we choose multipliers as 1, 1, 1, whether denominator becomes 0, y minus z plus z minus x plus x minus y. So y minus, what is the meaning of 1, 1, 1 multiplier? If we multiply y minus z by 1, so 1 multiplied by y minus z plus 1 multiplied by z minus x plus 1 multiplied by x minus y. Is it equal to 0? Yes, y minus z plus z minus x. So z get cancelled plus x minus y. So x get cancelled, y get. If denominator is equal to 0, numerator must be equal to 0. So here we have to multiply this 1, 1, 1 to numerator as well as denominator. And we have these three ratios. We get one more ratios. That's why we write it as each ratio is equal to dx plus dy plus dz divided by denominator, that is y minus z plus z minus x plus x minus y. So dx plus dy plus dz must be equal to 0 because denominator is here 0. After integrating, we get integration of dx is x, integration of dy is y, and integration of dz is z, which is equal to integration of constant is 0 is constant, which is c1. So first solution we obtained, x plus y plus z is equal to c1. Now to get the another solution, again we have to think one more set of multipliers. So if I multiply x into y minus z plus y into z minus x plus z into x minus y, is it equal to 0? Let us check. X into y minus x into z plus y into z minus y into x plus z into x minus z into y. So xy, xy get cancelled, xz, xz get cancelled, yz, yz get cancelled. So this is equal to 0. That's why here this x, y, z we can choose as multiplier. So if we consider x, y, z as multiplier, then we get again one more ratio, that is x dx plus y dy plus z dz divided by x, y minus x, z plus y, z minus y, x plus x, z minus y, z. So denominator becomes 0, numerator, equate numerator is equal to 0. So integrating, why? Because denominator 0 means indefinite. We want to convert it into definite, so we consider numerator is equal to 0. After integrating, integration of x is x square by 2, y is y square by 2, and z is z square by 2, which is equal to another constant c2. So we obtained as x square plus y square plus z square is equal to 2c2, denoted by b. So phi of u v is equal to 0 is the complete solution. So phi of u is x plus y plus z, and v is x square plus y square plus z square is equal to 0. So this is the first question. So second question is solve mz minus ny del z by del x. Del z by del x is nothing but p. Del z by del y is nothing but q. So pp plus qq is equal to r. So what is the value of p here? Mz minus ny. Q value is nx minus lz, and r value is ly minus mx. So dx upon p, that is mz minus ny, is equal to dy upon q nx minus lz is equal to dz upon r. that is Ly minus Mx. Again here the terms are in addition and subtraction, so we cannot use grouping method. We cannot neglect any variable because it is in addition and subtraction. So what we do, we choose multipliers. So choose multipliers as, choose multipliers as, now whenever there is a MN, LMN or XYZ term is there in problem, then always choose first set of multipliers as L, M and N. L, M, N. Choose first set of multipliers as L, M, N. So multiplied, each ratio is equal to L multiplied by dx plus M multiplied by dy plus N multiplied by dz divided by L multiplied by mz minus ny plus M multiplied by nx minus lz plus N multiplied by ly minus mx. So here LMN is a multiplier. So again check whether denominator is 0 or not. LDX plus MDY plus NDZ divided by L multiplied by LMZ minus LNY plus MNX minus MLZ plus NLY minus NMX. Okay, so if we observe it, LMZ, LMZ get cancelled, NLY, NLY get cancelled, MNX, MNX get cancelled. So denominator become 0. If denominator becomes 0, therefore numerator, that is LDX plus MDY plus NDZ, it is equal to 0. So what is integration of this? Integrating, we get L multiplied by X integration of dx, M multiplied by y plus N multiplied by z is equal to first constant C1, which is equal to first solution U. So this is the first solution which we obtained by using first set of multipliers. Now another set of multipliers is choose multipliers as one. Now how to choose multipliers here? Again, if we choose multipliers as XYZ, generally think about 1, 1, 1 or XYZ. If we choose here 1, 1, 1, then MX, MZ and MZ term is not there. So that's why we cannot choose here 1, 1, 1. But we can choose here XYZ. X multiplied by MZ minus NY plus Y multiplied by NX minus LZ plus Z multiplied by LY minus MX. If we choose this, it become XMZ and this become also minus XMZ. So it get cancelled. LYZ. So LYZ term is there, minus of LYZ. Similarly, minus of NXY plus NXY. So this will get cancelled out. So another set of multipliers as X, Y and Z. Now X, Y, Z is multiplier means its integration is X square plus Y square plus Z square is the answer. So each ratio is equal to X into DX plus Y into DY plus Z into DZ divided by X into MZ minus NY plus Y into NX minus LZ plus Z into Ly minus Mx. Just now we have seen that it is equal to 0. So directly I am writing here X dx plus Y dy plus Z dz, it is equal to 0. Integrating this, we get X square by 2 plus Y square by 2 plus Z square by 2, it is equal to constant C2. Now we denote this by V, which is X square by 2 plus Y square by 2 plus X square plus Y square plus Z square is equal to 2C2, or it is equal to another constant B. So this is the second solution. Now write down complete solution, which is phi of UV is equal to 0. So phi of U value is Lx plus My plus Nz and X square plus Y square plus Z square is equal to 0. So this is the solution for the second problem. Next example is solve x into 2 y to the power 4 minus z to the power 4 into p plus y into z to the power 4 minus 2x to the power 4 is equal to z into x to the power 4 minus y to the power 4. So here again we write capital P, which is x into 2 y to the power 4 minus z to the power 4. Q is equal to y into z to the power 4 minus 2x to the power 4, and R is equal to z into x to the power 4 minus y to the power 4. So solution is dx upon P, that is x into 2z y to the power 4 minus z to the power 4, y dy upon y into z to the power 4 minus 2x to the power 4 is equal to dz upon z into x to the power 4 minus y to the power 4. Now consider two two ratios, that is dx upon, see, if we consider here ratios, again same addition subtraction terms is there, so we have to choose here multipliers. Choose multipliers as. Multipliers as. Now see, here x term is there. If it is 2y to the power 4, then can we cancel out this 2y to the power 4 here? No, because here no 2 term is present. So we have to multiply here by 2. Then next z to the power 4 and z to the power 4. So it will get cancelled out. Next 2x to the power 4. Here also we want 2x to the power 4. Means what? We don't want this z, y and x. If we directly add it and here if we multiply it by 2, we will get multipliers. Means can we choose multipliers as 1 by x, 1 by y and 2 by z? Can we choose like this? So if we choose like this, then this x, y, z get cancelled and here we will get 2. So choose this multipliers, each ratio it is equal to 1 by x, that is dx by x plus dy by y plus 2 dz by z divided by x divided by x into 2y to the power 4 minus z to the power 4 plus y divided by y into z to the power 4 minus 2x to the power 4 plus z 2z divided by z into x to the power 4 minus y to the power 4. So this all will get cancelled out. We will get denominator is equal to 0, means numerator is equal to 0. Dx by x plus dy by y plus 2dz by z is equal to 0. Integrating. What is integration of dx by x? It is log of x plus log y plus 2 into log of z is equal to constant of integration. So it is log of x into y and 2z, 2 log z becomes z square. So is equal to c1. So we consider this c1 simply as log of c1, so that we can cancel out log on both sides. So log of c1. Now x, y, z square, it is equal to c1 and this is our first solution u. Now we have to think again about second type of multipliers. So choose multipliers as. So here remember one thing, if there is extra x, y, z term is there, then directly think about 1 by x, 1 by y and 1 by z. Now choose multipliers as. What will be the another set of multipliers? Now see, in this equation we have power 4. So if this power 4, x to the power 4 here, y to the power 4 and z to the power 4 become, then we will get answer. But again last term must, we will get answer. So can we simplify this? Can we choose here multipliers as x is here. So x, to convert this x into x to the power 4, we have to use x cube. Then next y cube and z cube. So choose multipliers as x cube, y cube and z cube. Each ratio is equal to x cube into dx plus y cube into dy plus z cube into dz. Now see, divided by x cube into x become x to the power 4 into 2y to the power 4 minus z to the power 4 plus y cube into y is y to the power 4 z to the power 4 minus 2x to the power 4 plus z is z to the power 4 x to the power 4 minus y to the power 4. Now we check that whether it is equal to 0 or not. So you can simplify it. X to the power 4 you can check here, x to the power 4 2 times y to the power 4 minus x to the power 4 z to the power 4 plus y to the power 4 z to the power 4 minus 2 y to the power 4 x to the power 4 plus z to the power 4 x to the power 4 minus z to the power 4 y to the power 4. So check that 2x to the power 4 y to the power 4, where is 2x to the power 4 y to the power 4. So this is 2x to the power 4 and 2x to the power 4 y to the power 4. This is x to the power 4 z to the power 4 y to the power 4 z to the. So all term will get cancelled out. Therefore we can write this equation as x cube into dx plus y cube into dy plus z cube into dz is equal to 0. Integrating we get x to the power 4 by 4 plus y to the power 4 by 4 plus z to the power 4 by 4 is equal to c2. So we obtained x to the power 4 plus y to the power 4 plus z to the power 4 is equal to another constant b, where 4c2 is equal to b, and this is v, another solution. So write down solution, phi of u v is equal to 0, that is x, y, z square, and x to the power 4 plus y to the power 4 plus z to the power 4 is equal to 0. So you can solve more examples on this method of multipliers by choosing multipliers related to the problem. And if you have any doubt, you can ask that doubt to me. Thank you.